a little song I wrote. You might want to sing it note for note. Don't worry.
Be happy. Hello and welcome to Smile and Spread a Little Joy. I'm your Smile Lady here in the Smile Haven, and I have a special guest for you today. But in case someone's just tuning in for the first time, even though I'm the Smile Lady, that doesn't mean everything is funny. And I really want to break down the smile to you, and I want you to smile, because everyone born was born to smile. We were not born to leave this place worse than it was. We were born to make people smile. You don't even have to go to Google to know that. We were here to leave this place better. Another thing I like to say, you know my series is Grandma's Hands and Choosing Joy. Give your mother, your friend, or whatever their flowers while they are living, because they cannot smell them while they're gone. So please, remember to smile, share some flowers, grow your own garden, compost. It is just a simple thing to give. It doesn't cost that much to smile. Now I'm going to break down the smile. They should have support, motivate, invest, love, and educate on the screen right now. And what I want you to do, and I'm going to break that down, the S is for support, because it takes a whole village to raise one child. The M is for motivate. Don't hate, motivate. If you want to do the N, M, and then motivate. Oh, the I is for invest. Leave this place better than you found it. When we leave, the world should not be the same, worse, it should be better. Leave it better than you found it. The L is for love, and we're talking agape. We're not talking about love that hamburger, your shoes, your hat. We're talking about loving a person even when people think they're unlovable. We're supposed to love bin Laden, not what he did. We're supposed to love, that's a commandment. We are to love. And true agape is loving even when you don't feel like it. You love that person. Then E is educate. Train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it. Or let me just take you to Frederick Douglass. Knowledge is power, or knowledge is strength. Only the strong would survive. Remember this, you cannot get a brain transplant. Even if you did, you wouldn't be yourself. You'd be whoever's brain that was there. So you cannot get a brain transplant. Take care of your brain. It has to last a lifetime. That is your total smile, and we were all born to do that. So the colors, let's repeat that. If they put up number 9 really quick, the colors in smile, I do operate in colors. And the yellow, the blue, the green, the orange, and the purple all mean something. So when you see me come into your school, I have, or your senior center or your church, I operate in colors. This is the syllabus, and I added gray for the wisdom of our grannies and our elders. So the 5 basic colors is support, motivate, invest, love, and educate. And I usually wear the colors on the week that I'm teaching. So anyway, thank you for smiling here at the Smile Haven. Keep tuning in, because you can be a guest on the show. You can feature your grandmother, godmother, any mentor. You have something to smile about. Come on down so I can weave a smile into your purpose and your talent. Well, Aunt Granny is here.
It's been a long time.
I've been looking for Aunt Granny for like 4 years. She needed to whip me into shape. Pal Fonseca, I don't know if you know Tyler Perry and Madea. Well, today you're gonna meet the Aunt Granny side of Pal Fonseca. Wonderful words of wisdom. Keeps me in line. Maybe future guest hosts, keep tuning in. If you like her, I want you to write, call me. I'll give you a special gift. But Aunt Granny, here we come. Pal Fonseca. Oh, hi, Aunt Granny.
Hey, honey, how you doing?
Oh, my goodness. You just smiling. I don't even have to know what makes you smile. What makes you smile?
These here pretty yellow flowers right here. I was just sitting here thinking, now that is my favorite color, and that gal didn't even know that.
I didn't. So you want to take them home? You can take them home.
Oh, really?
Yes, you can.
Lord have mercy, I sure do want to thank you. And you've been so busy.
Yes.
And I've been just sitting here listening. I said, well, listen to that old gal. She know what she talking about. talking about smiling because you know and love and stuff because God is love, you know, and God gives you joy. And that joy will keep you smiling. I don't care what you be going through. Mm-hmm. I don't care what you be going through. But if you got some of that joy that God done gave you, you sure enough will smile. They be saying, she must be crazy. Children done be acting crazy. You know, you don't have the money that you need and all that kind of stuff. You just sitting there just smiling. Folks think you crazy. You smiling because you know God's going to take care of you.
That's it. You tell it. See, that's what
is the truth.
That's it. So what you think is the cause of the kids just going haywire now? Just come on, give me some of these words of wisdom. I need help in these schools.
Well, you know.
Better get my pencil out.
Well, see, it is what it is. Now, if you really wants me to tell you what I really think.
Yeah, I want what you really think.
What I really done seen, because I done lived me long enough to be done seen me some stuff.
Okay.
Because I done lived me long enough that, honey, one days I got up there, and I want to tell you, child, I ain't seen you for a while, but the one days I got up, and I put on my best dress, and I put on my best Sunday hat. And I want to have you to know that my great-great-grandson, he done come by and he done picked me up and he took me to the voting place.
Uh-huh.
And I voted the first black man to be the president of these here United States. And okay. I done lived me long enough to see that.
Okay.
So then I done lived me long enough now to see that the world is kind of in a fix. Now, I hope don't nobody's be getting mad at me, but see, a lot of it got to do with us women.
Uh-oh.
It do? Yeah, because us women, we done made some bad mistakes.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I've been there, I done made me some too.
Mm-hmm.
But if you think about it, a lot of the children, they ain't got no daddies in the house. But sometimes you got to think about, I know they talk about what they call them deadbeat daddies and
mm-hmm.
things.
Mm-hmm.
But sometimes you got to think about deadbeat mamas.
Uh-oh.
You see, it's because they weren't raped.
Mm-hmm. Uh-oh.
And they was just out there having a good time and souls and well, now it's the truth. You see, folks be looking for love all in the wrong places, and he come along and he say, I love you, and she believe it. And then before you know it, she got a young'un, then he gone off. Then nothing come along because she just be searching for some love, needing somebody to hug her and stuff, and nothing come along, and he says, I love you. Well, she believed that. Then she's got herself another child, and it just goes on. And then she look around, ain't no man in the house. Ain't nobody there to show the little boys how to do nothing, you know. They don't know how to run no money. A lot of boys ain't never seen the man shave. Do you know that? That's the truth. Done lived a whole lifetime and he ain't seen no man.
Or
you
how
know?
To use the bathroom.
I'm telling you, that's the truth. Mm-hmm. That, and little things like that mean a lot.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because you it's in the blood. It be in the blood. Life is in the blood.
Do you believe this? Now, I've been saying this and I want any woman to challenge me. Come on the show. We can challenge me. I truly believe that a single woman cannot raise a man. She could just raise a grown boy. It takes a man to teach a man how to be a man. Now, you have a grown body, but with a boy mentality, you need positive male role models. What do you think about that? We need a man in there to teach him how to be a man.
That's the truth.
Oh, so we agreed, right? Do you think some of these grandmas are enabling their daughter? They make it too easy for them to go out and have another baby?
Yeah, because see, what happens is the grandmas, they be thinking with their heart.
Oh.
They do. We think with our heart. So when the girl be done dropped the children off with us, we go ahead on and feed them. Because that's all we know is to feed them. You know what I'm saying? And so, and we don't know about a whole bunch of the worldly stuff that they be out there doing. So then a lot of children, they be in the grandma's house and they just be restless. You know, because all grandma can do is just tell them what the Lord says. You know, and give them some good food. But then the boys and the girls, too, they get restless, you see.
Mm-hmm.
And they just goes out there and they learns the wrong thing. And then sometimes they don't know where the mama is. They don't know where the daddy is. But see, it all boils down to, they got to stay up out of the bed. That's what it is. Now, that's you just want to know the truth.
Just the truth.
See, they be giving themselves away too soon. You know, young girls like 14, 15, they be giving themselves away and they don't even know nothing about themselves.
So that, let's go to the love there. So they should love themselves and know what they want to do first.
Girl, now you done hit it on the head. See, you got, I listen to the TV and I'm thinking, Lord, that ain't right. That ain't the way it's supposed to be at all. I heard one woman say, that old on that girl type show, and she said, well, child, you knows I's got to be serviced. I said, you ought to be ashamed of yourself for even saying that. I wouldn't even say that I's got to be serviced.
Service.
Lord have about? Mercy, what has done come to? Ooh. What is it done
it's
come
a service,
to?
Doing their business.
Yes.
Like what color purple, huh?
Lord, I's got to be serviced. And what that come out of a woman's mouth, she's not to be ought to be ashamed to say, look at him. Then they said, well, honey, if he can't do nothing for me, what is it you wants him to do? Then they say, I done heard them say, well, child, you bring 50 cent to the table, and I bring 50 cent to the table. No, that ain't the way Lord done hooked that thing
how
up.
How it's supposed to be.
They're supposed to be. Whatever it is, just like you and me sitting right here now, you bring 100% to you, and I bring 100% of me, and now we's got a whole thing that we
200%.
Can work with. We got a whole thing we can work with. But how am I gonna think about will I'm gonna bring half of me.
to the and situation. They think they smart. Yeah,
I'm gonna bring half of me to the situation. Then you already starting out with a mess right there.
So the support, you trying to say, you know, sometimes grandmas help too much and they going out there and having more babies. And then
you
we
see
make it too
that,
easy.
That grandmoms don't want to see their blood out there and souls. And I know that I don't want no, they don't be in no foster home. And I thank God for the foster homes. But
they don't teach
but
that
me,
stuff.
I'd rather have my blood in my own self's house. And sometimes that'd be a hardship. That'd really be a hardship. But we grandmas, we just go ahead on and take the hardship because and to keep them from being out there, you know, and your blood be somewhere else. Because you know what? Men don't care where they put their blood. Mm-hmm. You know, you can go to the bank, child, or you can go to buy you a house. They ask you all kind of questions. They want to know everything about you before they give you any money. Do you know that men don't ask women nothing and they just go ahead on and put their seed right there in a
don't even know her last name.
Don't even know half
that's
time.
That's why they
don't
call her baby.
Know.
That's why they got the song, Say My Name, Say My Name, huh?
They don't even know your nothing name. About the woman, and they give the woman their everything.
That's why.
Because when you give a woman yourself like that, you done gave her everything you is.
Oh,
you Lord. Done gave her everything you is, and you don't know nothing about her. And some men and putting their stuff in the bank. And I thought, Lord, no, they ain't. I heard that on... You gonna put your stuff in the bank now, and you don't know who got it. Now that's the most terrible thing I ever heard of. Lord, I don't know. You just got your blood everywhere, and you don't bit more know where it is and nothing. You don't bit more know what's happening to it. You don't know nothing about it. You just done gave your blood out there to somebody. Lord, have mercy. The world's in turn to fix.
Well, wait. You know what, Auntie Grant? I love you. You need to come to the school. Look, need to be coming to the schools with me to talk to these guys. I see you got change we can believe in. You proud of our president, huh?
Oh, yes, I see.
What you think about Michelle?
Well, see, she just as sweet as she can be. But you know what the thing is, what I tell them? Don't y'all know that there is hundreds and thousands of young black folk, and I got to talk about the black folk because that's who God knows about. Mm-hmm. But there's a whole bunch of them out there just as pure as they can be.
Really?
It's a lot of them. But you see now on television, they don't tell the truth about them. Uh-huh. That's what that is. Mm-hmm. See,
they show the prison and the gang.
They show them everything bad about black folks. And they show it all over the world. They showing that ain't right. That ain't right. Because I'd be proud to be an American. I'm an African-American, and I'm proud of that.
You from Africa?
Yes, I am.
You are?
Yes, I am.
You know what part?
And I don't know what part because you know how we done got him. You know, so I don't know what party it is, but I do know that I'm from Africa, and I'd be proud of that. And so is that our president, and he's proud of that. And we's got a whole bunch, because I see them sometimes, you know. I see them children. All our children ain't bad. I declare our children ain't bad. I go to church every Sunday, and then at our church, we go to other churches, you know. Because I had myself.
I don't mean to be laughing at you, Auntie Granny, but you saying what I feel like saying. You need to be a host on this show.
No,
you are just gone. Keep going, and I hope they'll show that artwork. And Africa is not a country, it's a continent. Maybe they'll find that.
It's a big place.
It's a big place.
It's a big place.
They have South Africa, which may be a country, but Africa is a continent. I don't even think our children know that. I know one of these people running for president didn't even know that.
I understand. I know it's a big place, but sometimes them words.
Continent.
Continent.
Asia, Africa.
Oh, yeah,
North
yeah.
America,
yeah.
South mm-hmm. America, Europe, Antarctica, Australia.
Because my children be trying to show me stuff on the computer. I don't know nothing about that thing, but I like it because you know what the Lord done said.
What he said?
He gonna say that everybody gonna hear my word.
Oh, see?
Before he come back, everybody gonna hear it. Now look at that, and them children be talking all over the world on them computer things. I said,
and
that's
Twitter.
What the law.
Twitter.
I don't know what the Twitter thing is, but that's what the law was talking about. Everybody gonna hear.
Oh, see?
Every knee gonna bow for me.
Mm-hmm.
That's what
even
he done
if
said.
Even if it's on Twitter, huh?
Yeah,
well,
even if it's on Twitter.
Twitter is this little bird on the computer, mm-hmm. and it goes like a little birdie told me. You know how we used to say, a little birdie told me? Now instead of the little birdie telling you, it's this little thing called Twitter, and it's a bird that just go boom, boom, boom. And you can only type a few characters. It's for these quick notes, and it gets all over the country. Quick. Ain't that something?
Well, I declare.
Mm-hmm. We digital immigrants. I'm learning this from the digital natives. Digital natives are anybody born 1980 on. We immigrants.
We're
you
not.
Got a heavy accent because you don't know what a mouse is.
Yeah, no, I still don't.
You don't know what a mouse is? Guess what the mouse is? Mouse is that little thing. They used to have a little mouse that looked like a mouse, mm-hmm. but now it's your little finger that you roll over the screen, and you get to click, 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 and the mouse kind of eats like the little cheese on the screen. Let me break it down to you. That's what it is.
Mm.
That's your mouth, huh?
You know what we used to do?
What?
We used to do it with drums.
Drums?
That's what we used to do. We could tell the whole story. We tell the whole story. I heard my grandma talking about from village to village, they do it on the drums. And so then when we come here to America, we do it in the field.
Mm.
And they start a song right here.
Mm.
And that song would go from that field to that field to that field.
Do you know what I'm finding? They did more without the Twitter than they doing now with the Twitter.
They sure did.
We did the civil rights movement, didn't have cell phone, computer, nothing. Got more done than we sitting up here Twitter. We too busy Twittering to get out there and do something, right? You know,
well,
I think we should.
Well, now, wait a minute.
Uh-oh,
now, about
go
the
ahead.
Twitter thing. I thank God for those things.
Yeah, I do too.
I thank God for
them.
I don't know how to use them, but I'm sure God is in it.
Yes.
You see, now, you got to see that the devil going to be everywhere.
Yes.
That's him. You mm-hmm. see, because that's his job, to come mm-hmm. and destroy and to kill and to fool folks and to lie to folks. Mm-hmm. That's his job.
Mm-hmm.
But Jesus be there.
Okay.
So it's this Twitter thing. I can sure promise you that Jesus is in that thing.
Okay. And the thing is, but we got to get from the Twitter and then do something. Like, what does it say in James? Faith without works is dead?
That's right.
Twittering without works?
That's right.
It dead.
That's right.
So that's where the devil come in. Make you sit in your room and just Twitter, but not do nothing. Do you know that I can look at kids now and they face look like a screensaver? You know what a screensaver is?
No, I'm giving you an ass. What's that? What's
okay.
that?
Screensaver is like if you're away from your computer for so long and there's no action, so when the kids zone you out, it's screensaver, and you can have your grandkids' pictures showing up, or dolphins, or trees, and stuff like that. So it saves your screen from being burned, the text being burned into it. Well, I can look at children now that's not used to talking to people. You talk to them for more than 5 minutes, their face look like a screensaver like that.
Oh.
You know, we used to say lights on, nobody home.
Yeah.
I call it the screensaver look.
That's true. They look like they just don't.
They look like they just tuned you out.
But you know what? Now that's, because I didn't see that too. I didn't know what it was called. You know, my grandma, she used to say, come here, let me put the sense in you. She take her thing like that. Because she was thinking that nobody was listening to her.
Mm-hmm.
But I tell you, you've got to keep on telling them what's right, though. Even when they tune, when they look like they tuned out, mm-hmm, you mm-hmm. just keep on telling them, and you keep on telling them what's right, because there's going to come a time when it's going to come to the front, when they's going to need that.
Yes.
So we got to put these yellow, we got to put these flowers in their brain.
Mm-hmm,
we
mm-hmm.
got to put the beauty of the flowers in their brain.
Mm-hmm.
We got to put the beauty of what thus says the Lord in their brain.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we used to be thinking sometimes that they ain't listening to us, but it come that time, you know, because a whole bunch of stuff that I didn't need, this when mamas and daddies were talking to me, I didn't need it sometime till I got about 40 years old, some of that stuff. Mm-hmm. But so we put that in there, we just got to put it in there, and we put it in there with love.
That's it. You know, I know we have 5 minutes, and I should be hearing my music, I Choose Joy.
Oh.
And Veretta Heidelberg is somebody that's really local, and she's spiritual, and you have brought so much joy. You show me your support of the children. Your motivation is just seeing these little kids just running around just with no sense. So you just bring them and say, let me put some sense in your head, right?
Mm-hmm.
You invest it back
you
to the community.
You bring them to you.
Yes, you invest
you.
Back by coming out and doing these speaking. You speak all over the country. I know right now you're over the United States because this is international. Then I don't hear my music. I Choose Joy. But they're going to put it on in a minute. But the thing is then the love. I could tell you love the children.
Yeah.
You just love them. Your education. What type of education do you have? She has 5 minutes up here right now. So the music I should hear. Okay. So the education. What type of education did you get?
From my mama and my grandma and
That's
living
it.
Child. I done lived me long enough to have me some education. I done lived it. That's what that is.
Mm-hmm.
I done lived it. Well, my school days, they was no, wasn't that much of that. So ain't me even talking about that. Ain't no easy me talking about that. But I tell you what. Honey, what I do know, it shows been me surviving. It's been mm-hmm. me surviving, my children surviving.
Common sense.
Do you know, now listen here, I'm just going to bring his name in right quick there, because I watch Dr. Phil, because I be watching him, you know, because he done been to school and stuff. And that Dr. Phil said one day that common sense is coming back this year. I said, well, glory, hallelujah. I watched Dr. Phil because he got common sense.
And do I hear my music?
Common sense.
Maybe it's too low. I Choose Joy by Veretta Heidelberg. I know I should have a few more minutes because they held the 5 minute song. I Choose Joy. I don't hear it. Do you hear some music?
No, just the music from Hip 'Em. That's all I hear.
Just from Heaven.
Sometimes you know.
Maybe it's busted.
You can just hear your angels.
Okay.
When you quiet yourself, when you get
she
yourself good and quiet.
Minutes. Okay. Got it.
You can hear the angels, and they still come and sing to you.
Okay. Well, we got signals crossed. It's just me up here. One is doing hold up 5 minutes. One holding up 7 minutes. I'm new at this thing. I'm so new at this thing. But what I want to do, Auntie Granny, I really like the fact that grandmas need to step back in there with wisdom and not be afraid to be old-fashioned and be a granny. I'm a great-grandmother now, as of April 29th.
Yes.
And so now I have an effect of three
great-grandmother. Well, that's nice.
And I have 11 grandchildren by June 17th. And I'm just up here, I'm in this surreal moment. And I know you have, how many grandkids you have?
I don't know, child.
100.
They come, and they just keep on coming. And child, when we had them old family days at the house, they'd be so many folks running around there, child, we just try to feed them all. That's all we do, feed them all, love them, hug them, kiss them.
You know what, since you're gonna come back and be guest host, and these yellow flowers are gonna be yours, because I believe
in giving
your flowers.
I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna be do what?
I want you, when you come back, you gonna come back and be guest host.
And what's that?
That's sitting here, and you're going to take the smile seat, and you're going to interview people.
This seat right here feel pretty good to me. Ain't
nothing
wrong with this here chair.
Well, you can sit there and do it, and I'll sit here. But I want you to look in your camera and give some advice to the young folk or the grandmothers that are right there. Just look in the camera. Right there, number three.
Well, you got me here on the spot, but I guess the most important thing I can tell anybody is that Jesus works.
Mm-hmm.
I declare he does. He done died for us. And Heavenly Father, all we's got to do now is live for him and everything gonna be all right. I don't have no great philosophy thing to tell nobody. All I can tell you is Jesus works.
Mm-hmm.
That's where it works for me. And keep on loving yourself. Now that's the truth. You get yourself together before you be out there trying to get somebody else to make you happy.
That's it. You make
yourself happy first.
That's it.
You know, you get your thing together. Folks are always looking for somebody else to make them happy. They gonna move in with somebody else. Move in with yourself first. That's the first thing you've got to do is to work on you. Shoot, just do yourself. Do yourself good.
Do yourself right.
You know. And then when you find anything, you a whole you. And you don't be needing all that old outside stuff to be making you happy.
You know what?
Just go to sleep.
That's it. And you know what? you keep smiling, and they'll put up their smile at pacbell.net, because we're going to have Pal Fonseca as a guest on this show, where you can really talk to her and see what makes her tick. She done sent Auntie Granny, and she's made me smile. I love it. So smile at pacbell.net, and smile, www.smilelady.org if you want to see about the program, want to be a part of the show. And like she said, love yourself first. If you've ever rode in a plane and you're taking care of somebody, they say you put the oxygen mask on yourself first before you can help someone else. So that love is the oxygen. That love is the life source. And if you want Auntie Granny at your place, you call me at 626-797. They can put the card up, 3760. So thanks for coming to the Smile Haven. They'll roll over pictures. They'll roll over everything while I am smiling with Auntie Granny. They can get, you are just so, I just love you. These are gonna be.